হ্যালো। একদিন সূর্যের ভোর, একদিন সত্যের ভোর, একদিন স্বপ্নের ভোর আসবে। দিস ইজ দ্য সং আই ইউজ টু সিং ওয়েন আই ওয়াজ ইন দিস কলেজ 32 years ব্যাক। And it is so nice to be back again with you to share the dream that we had that time, that the beautiful dawn will come. We promised that the beautiful dawn will come, and to tell you the story about how things are happening. I will be talking about a butterfly which flapped her wings in 32 years back. Yes, being a scientist, I need to talk about a butterfly effect. I need to talk about fractals. You must know about butterfly effect. What happened? It can create explosion. It can create explosive growth. How can you have this explosive growth? You see the population, it has explosive growth. Why? Because it is self-propagating, it is self-generating. So if a system is self-propagating and self-generating, then it is going to be an explosive scenario. And that is what is called butterfly effect. The initial condition, if you change little bit, very little, if you change the initial condition, that can create a huge impact. And perhaps we need that butterfly effect in India. Now, there is a connectivity between this butterfly effect and fractal. I did work on fractal geometry, and you will be really happy to know that fractals is everywhere. It is everywhere. If you see, look at the plants, look at the trees, you will see the leaves, they have some self-similar pattern. If you see the cauliflower, this cauliflower, it is flower inside another flower, and it keeps on growing like that. So the geometric pattern that is repeated again and again in smaller scale, and you get the fractal pattern. And why fractal? Because you know nature? Nature loves simplicity. So anything nature creates, it creates a unit cell. You have seen, we have cell, it is so simple. You have nucleus, you have protoplasm, and all these things we have. You have single cell, you have seen the egg. So there is a single cell that is there, that is the unit that was created by nature. And then what happened? That is multiplied, that is changed, tweaked here and there a little bit. And then finally you get the complex shape. Because nature creates complex shape by initiating a very simple feature. When I am going to talk about this fractal feature, I told you one thing, that is it is self-propagating. And the second thing is, it is repeating again and again. So if you can make some idea which is very simple and then keep on replicating it, you can create an explosion. The way the explosion takes place in fractal reaction, that is the nuclear fission. What happened, you know, one neutron is bombarded on the nucleus and two neutrons come out, then three again goes and bang on three nuclei. And then it keeps on growing, and you get a series of 1, 3, 3 square, 3 cube, like that, and gradually you get a exponential generation and exothermic reaction. It is havoc. Based on this concept, I came out with some idea some time back when I was finishing my PhD. And that time I was working on fractal geometry to understand the material's microstructure. high resolution microstructure you see under the microscope, and I quantified it using fractal concept. And I was thinking, we have such a huge problem in our country. We have so much of illiteracy, so much of problems with the educations and poverty. So what can we do? Can we create some fractal network? So the idea that came to my mind in 2010, that came out with a model which is called 1392. One facilitator create three tutors, they teach nine students, and the same facilitator link another two facilitators. So you see that 1392, this is the model of nuclear fission. And one thing that I realized, you can see in that slides that the presentation of 1392, this kind of model, you know, the our service delivery was education. Like one thing we realized when I interacted with the children, what I have seen, you know, their parents, they go out of their home and they do not take care of the children. And the children, they just roam on the road. There is no one to take care of them. So I thought, why not we create some community classroom? Why not we create some community mothers who will take care of these children? A small classroom like 10 to 15 children. And why I thought about community mothers? The reason is because if you see our society, like 50% educated women are underutilized. Their contribution to the society is not connected to GDP. They do so hard work at home, but it is not connected. Why can't we utilize that untapped resources to educate these poor children, to ensure they become the community mother? So we created a net, I started the class in my home back in 2011. I had three students. This is my first DLM students. Like three students, I started teaching. DLM means digital literacy mission. Why I call digital literacy mission? Because the concept is connected to computer network. Concept is connected to fractal network. That was the reason it is connected to digital literacy. There is another point that we wanted to teach the student computer, say, so that they learn, they have that information empowerment. But later on, when we started doing that, we realized these children, even they do not know how to write A, B, C, D. In fact, I had to sit and hold their hands to teach, this is the way you make a round like that. So it happened like that. We started the class in 2011, and that was the birth of digital literacy mission. That time, government did not have any policy of digital literacy mission. Then the idea that I had that time, that it has to propagate. That means this will not be only one center, there will be millions of centers. That was the dream I had. Because I wanted to do something, we wanted to do something exponential. So we had the first center, the students, the number started growing. We had 15 students, 25 students. I started connecting facilitators, tutors, and all. And now there is a nearly 25 centers in Jamshedpur, in Kolkata, in West Bengal. And we ensured that the women's are the community mother. Women's are the tutors. And these women's, you know, I tell them that you must teach these children like mother. So that they are not going out of their track. They are regularly going to school, they are learning properly. Those are the thing guideline was given. And one thing that we did, in fact, I would just refer to my mentor, Professor Prabal Kumar Sen. He is the founder chairperson of XLRI-EDC. He is there with me right now. I would rather borrow his way of saying things. Mita, it has threefold benefit. One benefit is like it is educating poor children. One benefit is you are giving employment to women. And there is another benefit that we do that I'm going to tell you later. Now that is the time of when I did this thinking about entrepreneurship, social entrepreneurship. You know, I don't know how many of you heard about social entrepreneurship. Can you just show me your hands? Do you know about social entrepreneurship? I did not know in 2011, but I came to know when there are class sessions was going on in XLRI. Then I thought I have to learn social entrepreneurship. Then I went and enrolled in the PGP batch of entrepreneurship development, and I was learning with students who are my daughter's batch age group. So you can understand my batchmate of batchmates are like you. So it was a really a challenge, but I enjoyed it a lot. Now, what I learned in entrepreneurship, that whatever you do, it has to be sustainable. How do you make it sustainable? Like one thing is, in entrepreneurship, there are three parts. One is fund generation, another is fund distribution, and another is wealth creation. Now in fund generation, that revenue we get. Now how do we do fund generation? Because we are doing fund distribution. We are giving money to the teacher who is teaching these children. Now, we thought that we have to make products. So that if we can make products, then that can be used for earning money and we can start getting money. And other thing is like wealth creation. What kind of wealth? That is skill, knowledge, profit, if there is any, because this profit is plowed back to the system. So, but thing is the skill, employment opportunities, these are the wealth that was created. Now, when I talk about the product development, you know, so it was like what kind of product I should develop? Because being a scientist in National Metallurgical Laboratory, there are a lot of things like which is you need a big plants, you need big materials. But one thing that I was quite fascinated with is electronic waste. So that was my project of entrepreneurship development course, that electronic waste management. And then I thought about why not design a program for teaching students how to make robots. I also have connection with grassroots innovator. One guy is there. He is helping us with coming out a lot of robotic things. And he used to do it with ice cream sticks and electronic waste. So he came to our team. So we designed a program called Make My Robo. So that program we run in Jamshedpur. And this is quite fascinating. The students, they learn things by doing it. The problem with our country, there are one thing that is, one is learning by knowing and learning by doing. I know all these engineering students, many of you, you do learn by knowing. You read books, you write answers, that is the way. But that should not be the true form of education. You have to know, you have to learn by doing things. You have to make things. Unless you make things, you will never be able to understand what is happening. Now that was the program we did. And other thing I was quite interested about, e-waste jewelry. So our team that I now tend to connect a lot of women who are learning entrepreneurship, and they are designing all this electronic waste jewelry, and which is pretty cool. I think if you see that, you would like to have one. So that is something that we did. And the other thing that I want to specially mention, that is called biodegradable bags. So one fine morning, I did not have any sort of work. I did not have to cook the lunch. So I had little time. So I used to play with paper. I used to do origami. And suddenly, I came out with a bag, you know. And I thought, oh my goodness, this is a bag we can use for throwing garbage. So why garbage? Why garbage you will use a paper bag? Because this is a challenge. Can you use paper bag for throwing kitchen waste, like the moist waste? You definitely say no, but we designed, because after all, I'm an engineer, you know, I have the skill of doing things in such a way that it will work. So I changed the design in such a way that it can hold moist kitchen waste. So I started doing that, making that bag, and even I used to make this bag with my mother-in-law, with my friends, who used to come, who used to make this bag, and we started selling this bag online. We sold nearly 25,000 bags in a year. So it proved that it works. And what this 25,000 bags, what is the meaning of that? You know that? 25,000 bags means 50,000 rupees. 50,000 rupees means 25,000 is for the women who are making this bag, and 25,000 is for the education system that we are running, that is digital literacy mission. So this is the way we started earning money, and this is the way we wanted to say that nothing is impossible. So you must be, then it comes one after another, that you can see there is a biodegradable banner, because I really hate plastics. You see that wherever you go, this is a flex banner. This is the flex banners. And flex banner is very harmful. You just think the amount of waste you create. Just think about it. So how to replace? Then we came out with the bamboo banners. And it's a very beautiful banner. So our women, like my intern, who are doing research, like entrepreneurship development training with me, they started making this one. And it is more than that. One, there is one lady, she is a very good singer. She said, I want to support your organization. I want to support. How do you support it? I can sing. So what I'll do, I'll teach singing. And after singing, whatever money I'll get, I'll give it to your organization. So this is the way music, poem, design, many more. That is the creativity and happiness that we share with all. So there is a huge journey that you can see. There is a biodegradable banner because we are very strong in terms of environment. Because unless, guys and girls, you are careful about this thing, that you will be producing very little waste. You will be producing very little waste unless you follow this principle. You are going to soon get the doomsday. So just be careful about when you are creating waste. How to replace with biodegradable thing. So there are ways to do that, and new innovation, new things can come up. So one thing that I told you, that fund distribution, you understood that what are the fund generation that we do. In fund distribution, we have three programs. One is digital literacy mission. I did not tell you another interesting program that we run. In fact, it is running possibly now also. This is called Kolkata Roadside Classroom. So we started in August under the Goriahat Bridge, and it runs from Sunday from 3 to 5. So today it is over. I just saw the WhatsApp message that they are saying that it is running well. The students, you know, the roadside students, they are doing painting and many things. You see this little girl, she is writing one board, and that board is made up of newspaper. I made that board because that is called soft board. And resources is always a challenge. Resources is always a challenge when you are working in this domain. So we needed blackboard or whiteboard, but where do we get the money? And this is also transporting a poor problem. So what we did, I made this diamond shaped newspaper flex board, or maybe soft board, and you can use four clips and fix a one-sided paper in that and teach the students. You can see the children, student is learning. So there are a lot of ways. If there is any problem, you look for solution. If there is a problem, there is an opportunity. Anyway, entrepreneurs, you know, they do what thing? They see a problem and they try to find out the solution, and they earn money out of it. There is nothing wrong in earning money. So if you are a for-profit organization, you will be using the money for your own reason. But if you are a non-for-profit organization, what we will do? You will put the money for some activity which is required for the organization. So I established, along with Professor Shen, that organization which is called Relearn Foundation in 2015. Relearn, I gave the name. The process of learning is learning, unlearning, and then relearning. The learning that you are having in BE College or IIEST, you have to unlearn when you go to your professions, you know, and then you have to again relearn. So there is a process of learning, unlearning, and relearning. So this Relearning Foundation, Relearn Foundation, it is to promote learning by doing. It is to promote women entrepreneurship. It is to support digital literacy mission. It is to support Kolkata roadside classroom. And I mean it, all of you to come and join me. Because you know what you can do? You can create butterfly effect. You can create butterfly effect. Because if we join hands, and if we can see that through me, at least 5 students are getting education. I came from a background where my father was the first generation learner, and I am the second generation learner. So what I know, the value of education, many of you must be having similar background like mine. And many of you must be feeling that what you have learned, the institute that gave you this IIEST, this institute gave me this education, and it is required that I give this back to the society. And that is my dream. The butterfly that flapped that wings in 32 years back, still I'm flapping, but still I need to make a butterfly effect. I need many of you come together and join my hands. Thank you so much.